Now, I am not going to speak much about Hahnemann and how Hahnemann was influenced to introduce mercury, because that is not going to help you much, honestly, okay? But in one line I can tell you that Hahnemann was influenced to introduce mercury only because of syphilis. Hahnemann witnessed multiple Franco-Prussian wars, and because of war there was epidemic, and because of epidemic there was syphilis and poverty. And because of syphilis, people were applying mercury ointment and mercury salts and suffering from poisoning of mercury, and they used to come with the poisoning symptoms of mercury to Hahnemann. And so Hahnemann decides to introduce mercury in homeopathy. Have you followed, Christina?
Yes.
So in one line I told everything. But how did mercury came into the medical world? Egyptian people, people from Babylon, were the first people who introduced mercury as a medicine. And of course then, Galen was the first person in medicine who said, oh, be careful. You can't use mercury much because mercury is extremely toxic. So the first person who talks about toxicity and mercury is Galen.
Let's go and keep going. Just making sure there's no interruptions so it doesn't go on. Still recording. Red, go.
Thank you. So now, why did this word mercury came, huh? I will put Jungian stuff also in this. I will put a lot of homeopathic stuff also in this lecture. And I will also put a lot of philosophical stuff also. So Romans was the first people who used this word mercury for this metal. Only because when it dropped on the floor, the small drops ran together and then join into a one big drop. You understood? And that is how, looking at the quick movement of the small globules that fall on the smooth surface, lot of philosophical thing came from that. So Roman observed the quality of mercury. You know, mercury is always in a liquid form, so when it falls down, immediately you see globes, and that it goes fast and joins. And so see how the mythology and symbolism develop. And so the first symbolism that developed was of merchants and travelers who travel, and not in a one place. Why? Looking at the action of the drop that travels and unites. Do you follow? And so lot of things then came into existence because of this traveling and then because of the merchant. So the symbol of mercury, if you see basically in mythology, is related to Hermes. Now Hermes is symbolized as a shoe with a wing. I don't know how many of you know this, but the symbol of Hermes So can you see this shoe with a wing? This is Hermes. And so there's a lot of thing mentioned in this, but Hermes is a Greek symbol. Hermes has nothing to do with the Roman symbol. Romans used to consider this symbol of merchant and traveler as a crafty and a charming symbol. Crafty and a charming symbol. But Greek people preferred to put on the Hermes a hat which has a wing, and a shoe also which has a wing. And they tried to project this as a messenger of the god. And then they tried to project him as a messenger between the earth and the heaven. In Indian mythology, Mercury is considered as a sperm of Lord Shiva. As a sperm of Lord Shiva. I don't know how many of you know about Lord Shiva, but I can show you the picture of Lord Shiva if you want. Those of you who don't know. Can you see this? Can you see this? So these are some of the pictures of Lord Shiva. It comes from the sperm. Shiva is considered to be the lord of all the yogis. And that is why small amount of burnt mercury is ingested by all the yogic tantrics in the India as an alchemical medicine to promote long life. So many yogic tantrics take the ash of mercury, put it on the tongue, even though it is toxic, because they feel it's a sperm of Shiva that they are taking, and that will improve their longevity and increase their effectiveness as a yoga instructor. So anybody who is a yoga teacher should try this. Don't do this, please. The potencies of mercury that were made by Hahnemann were made by the black oxide of mercury. Black oxide of mercury. And also from pure mercury. So there are two types of mercury that were prepared. But there is no difference in the symptomatology, in the proving. So today, very nicely, Christina Garelli said, "Oh, Dr. Master, I have mercury vivax. I don't have sol." She was correct. Because Materia Medica of vivax is little different than sol given by some authors, especially Borike. So vivax basically is a pure mercury, whereas solubilis is a black oxide of mercury. But both are mercury, but Garinia knew this difference very well. She told me in the coffee break. She is very knowledgeable. So you understood this part so far? Everybody understood?
Yes.
Okay.
We were taught that Merc Vid and Merc Sol were so similar that they were almost identical and they could be used.
Yes, but not chemical-wise. Chemically, they are totally different. So, let us see now the clinic part. Somebody knocks your door, knock knock, and comes into your clinic, and how do we understand that guy? Now everything about this person basically comes from the main delusion that he is surrounded by the enemies. So that's the main delusion. So surrounded by enemies, or Constantine Hering says in his Materia Medica, there is constant suspicion. He considers everybody as his enemy. In Italian culture or in Roman culture, there is a statement, man is wolf of men. Man is wolf of men. So there is a great degree of suspicion and paranoia in this individual. Hanuman, when he proved, and the provers were giving following description, morose, mistrustful, treated his associates almost insultingly, looked upon everyone as his worst enemy. So people who were the provers were looking each other as their worst enemy in a very suspicious way. Now let us see, this is what is written in the Materia Medica. And if you read Materia Medica from the basic classical authors, the word enemy comes very frequently. The word suspicious will come very frequently. Surrounded by enemies will come very frequently. But many times in clinic, we don't see these patients coming and telling me, "Oh, Dr. Master, this Elena who is sitting next to me is my biggest enemy." No, they will never come and talk like that. So what they will talk like that? First statement, "Doctor, everybody hates me. Everyone wishes me ill. And everyone wishes that I should die." Now this also indicates that, you understood? You understood? Is there a word enemy in this statement? No. This is what people will talk. Everyone is out to get me one way or other, including my friends. And such stories are not uncommon in my practice, where you will see people feel threat from another person, brothers, sisters, mothers, friends, whosoever in the society, because there is another rubric which comes very close to this: delusion, injury about to receive. So delusion, injury about to receive, that's the very characteristic of Mercury. The history of mankind is loaded with Mercury. Hitler. I don't have to speak much about Hitler. Stalin. I don't have to speak much about Stalin. Julius Caesar and Napoleon were some of the famous Mercury personality as I have analyzed them after reading their biography in Wikipedia. I analyze every symptom of their, and when I repertorize their case, Mercury came out very strongly in repertorization. So these are the people, and these are the people who have obtained absolute power in their life, and after gaining a lot of power, they started torturing people, provoked violence, towering in humanity. If you read the Stalin, he was the worst Mercury, because Stalin never trusted anybody, and people who were close to him, slowly he killed all of them. All of them. So if you take the rubric kill in the repertory, kill, and you say kill, and then over here you say kill is given under the rubric murder, you follow? And then you look, desire to kill the beloved ones. So let's see, desire to kill the beloved ones, let's see if there is a rubric like that. Look at that rubric, desire.
wants to kill the family with a hatchet. Sweet husband and a child. You have to find that delusion. Maybe it is given in the proving that he wants to even kill the person whom he loves. Yeah.
It's actually under husband impulse.
And then,
husband,
thank you. Thank you so much. And then, you know what happened, no? When Stalin was arrested, or when Stalin was questioned about his violence and all the things that he did against humanity, what is the first thing that he said? He viewed always himself as a god, huh? So this is typical dictatorial behavior. I am the captain of my own ship and my own deck. Something like that. And he behaved like a god because Stalin always decided who should live and who should die. Something like Hitler. Or who should eat and who should starve. And people around Stalin were so afraid that even when Stalin was about to die and his last breath, not a single person around him spoke against him. Why? They were afraid that he will kill them. Do you follow? So that kind of fright. So many times Mercury is there in the house. People around the Mercury will always be a little afraid, you know, not to speak much in front of him. Who knows, he'll attack. Who knows, he'll say something. Who knows, he'll behave like this. So basically, many Mercury people believe that unless you agree with me and you go along with me, it is good, or else you will regret. You understood? So malicious is one of the very important symptoms of Mercury. Malicious or intolerant to contradiction. And that is why many times people are afraid of Mercury people, because Mercury has got another symptom. Want of moral feeling. You will see Mercury, want of moral feeling. Disposition to become a criminal without a remorse. Disposition to become a criminal without a remorse. Now this is something very scary, no? So such erratic behavior is a powerful weapon, because it defies accurate prediction. Flying into a rage, staring someone down, and that's why the meanest motive of every Mercury people is power. I should have the power. I should rule. And another thing that goes simultaneously with that is his lowest appetite in life, and that is sexual excess, love for sexual perversity, all these characteristics you will see in Stalin. You know Stalin comes from which country?
Russia.
He's from Georgia. Georgia. But formerly USSR. USSR.
Yes.
United States of Soviet Republic. Okay. Good. So the more he tries to become God, the more he tries to become powerful, the more he isolates himself from the human race. That's very important. Why did you talk? Okay. The more, that's why I'm recording, huh?
No, no, no. I didn't hear what she said.
Okay. She said, repeat. The more he loves power and more he behaves like a god, the more he isolates himself from the human race. And then they feel very lonely and bored. There is a rubric in Mercury. Desire for company, alone being aggravates. Second is ennui. Ennui. So you know that story of Stalin, because many people tried to overthrow him, many people tried to murder him, many people tried to kill him. The more the attempts were made on him, the more he became suspicious and tried to finish those people off. Stalin had a very bad habit of inviting people in the night to womanize, to sex, for alcohol, for partying. But people were afraid to go to his invitation of party because they knew God only knows when this gets turned suddenly and he will shoot them and kill them. So people were literally afraid. Read the story of Stalin if you can. And then Mercury will go into your brain very easily. Of course. Now deep down into the mind of Mercury, there is one more delusion, as if he had committed a crime. So if you look at the rubric, delusion committed crime, delusion he has done something wrong, delusion he is a criminal, this is all part of Mercury. Now because he has a delusion that he is a criminal, that's the reason why he considers opposite person as his enemy. Mercury is a person who has almost no freedom to choose good over bad and evil, because the balance of psychic force in his character leaves him no choice. And what is the psychic force in Mercury? Syphilitic miasm. Strong syphilitic miasm. And that is why they have a fixed idea in their mind that he is a criminal, he is capable of violent act, he projects his sentiments on everyone else and around him. I trust nobody. I trust nobody. No one is to be trusted in this world. Everyone is probably like me, a criminal. But Mercury, lack of insight and degree of perceived suffering are reflected by other fixed ideas. Delusion, I am in hell. Delusion, I am in hell. Suffering the torments without being able to explain. Now this is very important. Suffering the torments without being able to explain. So there are many, many fixed ideas in the mind. Delusion about criminals, delusion about animals jumping on her, delusion he was about to die, he will be murdered, he will be persecuted, he is pursued by enemies, and he sees thieves in the house. So these are very great paranoias which Mercury patient can present with hypervigilance, suspicion, run very high throughout the remedy. And when this situation becomes too high, there is one defense mechanism. And the defense mechanism is delusion tries to shoot with a cane. Look at this delusion, Wanda. Delusion tries to shoot with a cane. Why? He has to protect himself. But like a fool, with what is he shooting?
Cane.
Okay, so this is one very strong phenomena which I wanted to explain to you. Now this I have explained to you more from the proofs of the classical authors. Now you may not get a major Stalin in your practice every time, but you will have a miniature Stalin every day. You understood? So you have to now compress in a zip file Stalin. You know a zip file. All of you know, huh? You all live in America. So it's a zip file, you compress him and then you will see compressed Stalin in everybody's family. Nobody is free from a mini Stalin, okay? Whether it's a child, whether it's a mother, whether it's your father, whether it's your husband, boyfriend. So look at all those qualities and you will think of Mercury in them. Let us see what makes them like that. Let us see what makes them like that. So, casualties. The first and the most important casualty is allopathic medicine. And the most important, what is the most magical medicine in the world? That suppresses very easily everything. The magical remedy in allopathy.
Cortisone.
That's the magic. That's the magic. It plays havoc in the inner structures, including cortisone cream, which you apply on the skin. Magic. Your skin disease goes away very fast. And then what else do we suppress very easily every day? Suppressing perspiration, deodorants. I don't know whether it's common in America. People
very
use
common.
Oh, very common.
Oh, very common.
Oh. Deodorants.
Yeah.
Antiperspirant with aluminum.
But nobody perspires here. Why are you putting?
Because they use all suppress.
Ever since I came to America, I never perspire, see, so why is the use of it? Okay. Anyway, I'm telling you from India, so, because in India we always sweat. So suppressing perspiration. Second comes in India, suppression of menses. I don't know whether you suppress menses or not in your country, but in India what happens? Absolutely. Because in India, what happens if there is a religious function, the woman says, no, I have to suppress my menses. Mm. Oh, I have to attend this marriage, I have to suppress. Right. But I don't think Christians do that because churches allow people in menses also. So I don't know how you suppress your menses.
Because they're busy, they don't have a period.
Because they are very busy, they don't want to have a period.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Yes.
They can suppress it for a year.
Does
all
she
year.
Have a brain or not?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Because she's busy, busy doing what?
That's not her, I mean, that's not her, but there are others that I've had. I did, my kid plays a lot of sports, I want her to be on the court.
Oh, then she should suppress her urine and stool also, because she's busy. Okay. Okay.
So can you clarify?
So any suppression of natural thing, any suppression of natural thing, becomes the biggest causative factor of Mercury. Remember that. Please read aphorism number 201 and 202 about miracles of disappearance of disease and their symptoms. Okay? Even Burnett talks a lot about suppression. Herring says he has seen lots of patients in United States where he was practicing in Philadelphia, where people were suppressing the foot sweat.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Latin America, Russia.
Now one person in Herring's clinic is worth noting. This guy who wanted to commit suicide in a very strong way, and whatever attempts you do to prevent him committing suicide, he will still go and commit suicide. And at that time he had a great heat in his head. You understood? And he breaks out with a lot of perspiration all over the body. And this desire to commit suicide comes whenever he sees an open window. So if the window is open, he wants to jump. And then Herring found out that for years and years and years, he used to put some talcum powder on his feet quite a lot. Like he used to literally put a layer of it to suppress the foot sweat. So Herring says the danger of this kind of thing can be going all the way till suicide. Now I have not seen this in my practice, but I respect his observation. You understood? So first is allopathic medicine. This is all this comes under allopathic medicine. So then we go to another cause or casualty of mercury. Are you enjoying this mercury?
Yes.
Good. Is deceived ambition. Deceived ambition. Because mercury, from the very young age, as a child, thinks I am the greatest, I am invincible, and I am the reigning and uncontested emperor. Now, why is this happening in children? Fantasy. Fantasy. Many autistic children, children with Asperger syndrome, even retarded children, children with epilepsy, children with neurological disorder, backward children, will many times go into the fantasy. Now how are this fantasy triggered? Television, Ninja Turtle, Pokemon, and all those sci-fi type of cartoons where you get lot of power, you understood? And then you try to conquer the world. You understood? Now see, you will see lots of movies also, Star Wars and this, and I don't know if you have seen that movie Lord of the Rings. How many of you have seen that movie? Oh, lovely. Lovely. I have made a whole PowerPoint on Lord of the Rings and homeopathy. I'll show you one day. Yes. And so this shows a lot of syphilitic character. And so when you see all those movies and all those cartoons and all those games and all those computer games, you feel, you understood? Powerful. And that is why this kind of thing really makes you feel that you are strong and you can fight and you can make people control, you know. So this is very important. So this whole seedling, the whole seedling of revolutionary, what the man we saw in the morning, correct? Revolutionary, argumentative, going against the, you know, fight with the country, fight with the law, fight with the system, has a seeding in the childhood where you are influenced. Now, I don't know what kind of television this man would have seen years back, but maybe books, maybe newspaper, you understand? Maybe something who has stimulated and put the seeding in his brain, and that's how this thing now continues. Because ultimately this power, my way or free way, my way or no way, something like that. Okay?
George Bush.
George Bush? What is George Bush?
I think that he might be.
Okay. Then give him that remedy.
Saddam Hussein.
Saddam Hussein. Okay. So that's why it makes them a dictator. It makes them a dominating person. It makes them a dogmatic person. So when the child is imprinted with such a dictator mindset, a simple movie, that family movie, Simpson. Look at the character of Homer. A very strong father. You know this Simpson, huh? But you don't know Homer?
Yeah.
So these are all very strong people who come in this cartoon and then they behave like exactly like that. The next 10 minutes, even though the serial is over at 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock also the child feels in that same dream world, you know. So all this comes in a very strong way. The second common thing which I will say is discords between the child and the parents. That's another very important causative factor. Now this you will see very nicely in the life of Hitler. You know that Hitler's father used to beat him a lot. Yes or no? Hitler's parent had got lot of conflicts. That's why Hitler's mother suffered from carcinoma of the breast. She died of a very bad cancer of the breast. And the surgeon who operated on his mother was a Jewish person. And he said, kill every Jews excepting this man, because he saved my mom's life. That's what Hitler said. Yes, Niyosha. Look at previous history. So, this is very characteristic. Conflict between mommy and daddy. Or conflict between an authority and non-authority. Boss and employee. Something like that. Politicians and countrymen. And as a revolutionary fighter, he feels very justified if he does this kind of behavior to them. And he has no guilt for his behavior. And that is why when they grow up, Mercury will have a very difficult life. A proper Mercury will never have a happy married life. The life is miserable. You will see multiple divorces, multiple relationships, multiple mistresses, multiple wives. You understood? A typical Mercury I'm talking about, huh? Because with this nature, do you think he can have a normal relationship? Huh? Do you? No. Thank you.
She says,
unless married to a Natra Muriatica. But even Natra Muriatica will run away after 5 years. And ultimately, in the last years of their life, when the power goes, when the health goes, they become very discontented with everything, everybody. And then they try to reproach everybody constantly. And that's how the life ends. The third causative factor in Mercury is egotism. Egotism means easily insulted and easily humiliated. You don't do much, but they feel insulted very fast. They need that respect. They need that appreciation. And if you don't give them, they feel insulted, humiliated. So ailments from disappointment is a very strong causative factor. Ailments from deceived ambition. One thing which I forgot was this conflict, discord with the friends. Huh? Takes everything into bad part. So remember this kind of ego, when you hurt the ego of Mercury, he becomes very violent and he can destroy you. Mercury does not believe in that principle, if you slap me on one cheek, give another cheek. No, he will never do that. Huh? He will always believe in eye for eye. And many times Mercury people are always sheep, but remember, the clothing of the Mercury will be of sheep, but inside they are wolf. So be very careful. So these are the causative factors of Mercury. It's 1 o'clock, we'll have a break. And then if I have time today, I will teach you the compensatory mechanisms of Mercury, which is also very interesting. So what is the compensation? So as I've told you, the seedings are there in the brain of the child at a very early age, that I am powerful, correct? And then he turns out to be a dictator. Now here, when I say dictator, don't literally think of Hitler's image, but he could be a child of autism also, who considers himself to be a dictator, or a child who is Mongol, or a child who is retarded, or a child who is backward, or child who is dyslexic, and they start bullying in the school. So bullying is a very important symptom of dictatorship, bullying somebody. Initiating fights, second symptom that should remember that the child is dictator. Initiating fights, inciting others. Intimidating everybody around him, does not hesitate to use a stick or a hockey stick or a bat to instill fears in others. There's a very nice rubric in Mercury. Anger so he could have stabbed everyone. Anger so he could have stabbed everyone. That's the rubric. He often intimidates other children in forming a band of brothers, a gang of brothers with him. And this, he slowly, slowly enters into a psychiatric condition known as oppositional disorder. Oppositional disorder. Please read this in the textbook of medicine. If you see oppositional disorder, the first remedy that should come to your mind is Mercury. The child is quite chaotic, confused, lack of sympathy, considers everybody as his enemy. Strong disobedience to everybody, including the family. Intolerance to authority, can be impolite, impulsive, and can use any sharp instrument suddenly at a slight offense. People who are in habit of using sharp instrument suddenly with a slight offense, think of Mercury. Mercury people never hide their rudeness. When Mercury child does not get his own way, they spit on the face of the people. That's a very common symptom. No matter how many times you admonish the child, no matter how many times you punish the child, Mercury child will never change. They are impelled to touch everything in the home. impelled to touch everything in the stores, everything in the schools. They tear everything. They tear the belongings of others. And they feel they have no control over their senses. If somebody intentionally tries to harm him, his sense of injustice prompts him to plan how to get back to him. He has a very strong sense of injustice, Mercury people. How to get back to the offender. That's why it is mentioned in the rubric malicious and vindictive. Everything has to go his way. Very unreliable in their promises. Mercury children are very unreliable in their promises. And many times they are expelled from the school, expelled from the organization. Many times he is so confused, he does not know which emotions to use when. If you see the rubric, weeping alternates with laughter, you will see Mercury. Look at the rubric, you all have computer. Check it. Weeping alternating with laughter. And that also indicates the stunted growth emotionally of a child, who like a foolish person will laugh and then weep. So this is all destruction, 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 if you see at the level of mind. But physical also, body is also liable to destruction. You have got loss of vision, ulcers, necrosis, caries. Caries of the teeth, caries. So there is a syphilitic breakdown of all the tissues. You understood? Teeth are never healthy in Mercury. Gums are having lot of pockets of pus. Gums are having lot of pockets of pus, and hence a horribly offensive odor from the mouth. And the mother will always tell the child, go and wash your mouth and then come and kiss me. You smell horribly. Don't come near me. The sister will say to the brother, don't sleep near me. The wife will tell the husband, please do mouthwash 5 times and then come to me. This is Mercury. Understood? Lot of impulsiveness in children. But as they grow old, they mature to control those impulsiveness and not react immediately and keep all their impulsiveness in their unconscious mind in a form of a shadow. You know what is a shadow in Jungian language. Shadow is everything that you dislike about yourself and you store it in your unconscious mind. And so as an adult you try to become tolerant, but this is many times futile, because sometimes very simple word which should not be harmful to many hurts the Mercury, and he impulsively brings out all the violence on you. So many times the internal tension in the head of the person comes out in a volcano, and destroys the opposite person. And that is why, if the impulses are remaining in a mind for a very long time and is not getting chance to come out because you have matured and you are restricted in many ways, what will happen to them? Dreams! All this violence will come out in dreams, Niyosha, in the form of frightful dream at night. And what are those dreams? Pursuing others with knife, with a knife. Dreams of thieves, animal, shooting. Now this is the best time to give mercury and see the dreams will slowly change from syphilitic to psoric dreams. Dream of what do you want? So many sorry dream I can tell you. Dream of a sea, dream of water, dream of garden, dream of tree, dreams of Niyosha, sorry dreams.
A lot of fear, fears and dreams, yeah.
But dreams of monster eating you up is a syphilitic dream, huh? So now Halloween is coming, all the hidden violence comes out in dream form, huh? Amongst children. Okay, let's go further. So now, another very important compensation in... See, I'll tell you, there are many people who sit very quietly in front of you, like a statue, as if they are understanding you, as if they are listening to you. But from within they are extremely restless. I tell you, it is just a wink of an eye and then they disappear from their seat. So restless they are. Now why? Because in the brain, in their mind, in their unconsciousness, in their unconscious mind, sorry, there is so much stuff going on. It needs a release mechanism. But it cannot release immediately because there are restrictions. So best way is to become restless. And that is why Mercury people are totally suffering from ennui. Gets bored very easily. Howsoever interesting you are, howsoever important situation it is. They will start a movie which they long to see for many months. They sit in the movie and then they go out and do nothing. And when they go out, they get bored and they come inside and see the movie. It becomes 10, 20, 15 times. And the parent says, did you really saw the movie? He says, yeah, I understood the movie. I don't need to see the movie. Or sometimes halfway through the movie, they go home and they aren't interested. But then when they go home, they go out to a restaurant. And then the restaurant, they go and meet. They need something very restless in their nature. So many, many times the wife, if you phone, where is your husband and he's a Mercury, the wife says, please don't ask me where is he. He can be at 10 different places. I don't know. You understood? That's Mercury. Muddleness of the head, that's the one which I will use. Or obtuseness of their mental operations. Total obtuseness. Obtuse. You can't think where they are at this time. They'll be either sitting in the garden or working in the office. And it's a Monday, it's a working day, and the wife says, what are you doing in the garden? No, I went to the office, I didn't feel like working. I came out. Huh? You can't just come out on a Monday morning from your office and sit in the garden and play with a child. That's okay. In the afternoon, I'll again go and join my office. Oh! Take a day off now. No, no. enough of God and now I go back to my office. See, these are the type of... You understood? But they are very brilliant people, very knowledgeable people. Now here, you should know something about... you know Zeus? About, you know some, what should I say, mythology? Who knows Zeus? Zeus. Okay, we say Zeus.
Zeus.
How do you
spell it?
Z-E-U-S. Zeus. Zeus means he is the most powerful person, very powerful in the heaven, and his wife is Nymph. N-Y-M-P-H. Now, Nymph is a very low-grade woman, prostitute type. And Hermes is the child born from that wedlock. Nymph is living on the earth. So we all are bloody nymph according to that mythology. Because we are bad people, we have been thrown back from the heaven. But our father is Zeus and he is staying in the heaven. I am teaching you mythology, okay? You have to please accept what I say. And so, he is the messenger, Hermes, okay, between the two worlds. And so, he is so knowledgeable about both the worlds. So, Mercury person is a highly, highly learned, highly gifted, highly artistic, highly talented, and can do multiple jobs, multiple works. He can be a good engineer, but can also be a good doctor, but can also be a good pilot, but can also be a good author. And they change. They can change very fast. They can change the profession. Tomorrow you ask me to become engineer, totally I'll be failure. I'll go into Ethusa Synapium or Gelsimium state. But Mercury will still be very best engineer. You understood? So that is what I'm trying to talk about. I don't know how many of you have studied the life history of that Peter Sellers. Have you heard of this man, Peter Sellers, who made some movie?
Yeah.
Irmala Duse and all those things.
Yeah.
So he was a typical Mercury. Very big violence. The way he brought up his children was full of violence. The way he treated his wife, extremely shabbily. But on a Friday night when the movie is going to release, he will hug and kiss his wife and get himself photographed at the Los Angeles theater. You understood? The moment the photograph session is over, give kick in her ass to the wife, get lost. That kind, you know? Peter Sellers. Ultimately, he dies alone in a hotel in England with a severe depression. Everybody left him in his life. He died a very bad death because of his depression. Got totally depressed. But typical Mercury, please go and read his life biographies. I have read lots of biographies in my life. Peter Sellers' one touched me. Charlie Chaplin's life touched me. Laurel Hardy's life touched me.
Who was Charlie Chaplin?
Charlie Chaplin,
his remedy was... His
oh, syphilitic. No, mother has a full-grown syphilis when he was born. The mother had a very bad syphilis. He was abused, so he was... Okay, now we are not going to discuss that.
Okay.
Remove, rub. I'm rubbing everything. Okay? But think of Peter Sellers next time and what I'm talking about. But look at his movie. He makes you laugh, no?
Yeah.
Pink Panther, you know, no?
Yeah.
That Pink Panther and Return of Pink Panther and he looks like a fool in the movie and makes you laugh, no?
Mm-hmm.
Look in his real life, he was a scoundrel. He was a dictator. He was a woman abuser. Can't make out. Why? Wearing a skin of a sheep, but from inside he is a wolf. Okay. So, where did I talk? Okay. So there's a lot of foolishness and hyperactivity in the remedy. So to become popular and to show that he is a dictator and to show he is a very powerful person, many times Mercury people become audacious. Audacious. Audacious means no sense of danger, or a boaster. Loves to engage in dangerous activity. They require energy. They love to do everything with energy, speed. You understood? They would love to stand on the roof of the car and tell the father, drive the car, I'll stand on the roof of the car. Roller skating, ice hockey, roller hockey, you know all those sports, no? Very dangerous, huh? And American football, oh God. I am sure out of 10 players of American football, 3 or 4 would be Mercury. I tell you. You know, no? When they want to catch the ball, everybody falls on you, oh God.
Big ones.
Huh?
The big
ones. Yeah, oh, I
they
know,
all
the
big... injure big time.
Huh?
And they punch you while they're falling on you. It's
horrible. Yeah. Yeah, I know.
So mild.
Very hard.
American football, I know Mercury. He is constantly moving around, unfortunately at night, which makes for sleepless night for him and his parents. There are so many rubrics regarding night and sleep for Mercury, I cannot tell you. But some are restlessness at night, driving him from one bed to another, restless after least exertion. Wants to put everything in the mouth, strange, ridiculous motions of the hand, fidgety fingers, very fidgety, touching everywhere, nonsensical speech with difficult articulation, amounting to stammering. Lot of stammering you will see in Mercury. So cannot sit in one place in the classroom. But as he grows old, all these things will disappear. But it is still there, very there, very much there in the back of the mind. You understood? And so how does he do now? When he grows old and he becomes a matured person and he is starting his own business, he will do everything in his business what he used to do as a child. You understood? Or in his personal life. So they either destroy the person with whom they are working in the business and become criminal or whatever, syphilitic, or syphilitic with their personal life. Never marry Mercury person, never. Only if you love to be destroyed and a premature death, go ahead. Okay. So remember, with all these things, the spectrum of depression is not very far away. It is hiding in the corner. And very soon the depression comes in. Because why it has to come when he has so much power, when he is so powerful, dictator, why?
Loneliness.
Yes, Niyosh? Loneliness. Perfect. 100 marks out of 100. Because everybody has given him a kick. Everybody went away, leaving him all alone. What will he do with so much money? Nothing. Depression. And that is the time that he has got an empire, but there is nobody living in that empire. At that time he feels estranged. At that time, he has aversion for family, they all left him because of his bad behavior. He is loathing for his life. And then he constantly struggles to kill himself. Constantly struggles for suicidal dispositions. Especially sadness comes in sunshine. Look at the rubric. Open your repertory. Sadness in sunshine.
Huh? That's weird. That's peculiar.
The remedy itself is weird. The man is weird. Now, sun is a symbol of happiness and light. And Mercury shuns the sun. He does not resonate with his inner being. Mercury loves black color. Why? Write down. The black color in Jungian psychology signifies sin, signifies hidden, signifies rebirth in seclusion and the personal unconscious. But most important is the sin. Was another person who was conquering the whole world and then ruling the whole world, traveled to another country, conquering the whole world.
Yes.
Correct! 100 on 100.
What was it?
Genghis Khan. There was a movie. Niyosha, you saw that movie? Good. See, you all know, you are so brilliant people. Now, hormonal problems destroy Mercury woman. Why? Great desire to murder or commit suicide during menses. That's the symptom. Great desire. So husbands have to be very careful.
Great desire for what?
Great desire to commit suicide or commit murder.
When?
During menses.
Heard
about the American woman. She backed over her husband and then she went forward and then she went back and then she went forward and then she went shopping. Wow. Yes. Write down. Sexual excesses is another very important area of Mercury. It's a very common outlet Mercury does to have full control over the other person. Now, syphilitic miasm has no control, remember that. And hence, sex will be totally uncontrolled, destructive in nature, destructive, nymphomania. Syphilitic people never evolve beyond superficial level. Syphilitic people never evolve beyond superficial level in love. And hence, the attitude is always sexual towards the partner. And sex is always abnormal. It's like a piece of meat the dog has to eat. Sex is like a piece of meat a dog or a lion has to eat so that he can bite the meat, he can hurt the meat, and then he can throw away the meat. You got it what I said? The way I told you?
Well, not really.
Not really.
Why did the what?
What happens if the lion kills a goat in the Africa jungle? What happens in Africa jungle once a lion kills the goat? He will bite it.
Yeah.
Then what will he do? He will hurt the goat. Yes or no? He will tear the meat. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
And then when his stomach is full, he will go away. That's how they do sex.
They discard the person.
Aha, lovely. Think of that. When somebody tells you this story, it is Mercury. Okay, golden tips from my clinic about Mercury. Write down, golden tips from my clinic. Okay, number one, heavy sweating in the sleep. Heavy sweating in the night. Headaches with a constriction sensation. Second tip, headache with constriction sensation in the night. All discharges are offensive in nature. Metallic taste in the mouth. Excessive salivation, making the pillow wet. Slightest change of temperature knocks them down. Slightest change of temperature. They are known as human barometers. Human barometers. They will feel everything about weather. They catch cold very easily because the defense mechanism is very poor, very poor. Intense thirst, even though the mouth is wet. Intense thirst. Number one remedy for swimmer's ear. You know what is a swimmer's ear?
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. Very good. Geographic tongue with imprints of teeth on the sides. Geographic tongue. Geographic. An important remedy for Parkinson's disease. Important remedy for any tremors. Very useful remedy for patients with AIDS, with swollen glands and recurrent fevers. With swollen glands and recurrent fever. Very useful remedy in my practice when the mercury fillings are removed from the teeth and the patient suffers from withdrawal symptoms. When mercury fillings are removed from the teeth and patient suffers from withdrawal symptom. Useful remedy in ulcerative colitis, especially Mercor. Great remedy for infectious mononucleosis. Nucleosis. Giving low potency of mercury hastens the suppuration. Giving high potency absorbs the suppuration. Mercury is worse by heat of the bed. mercury is worse by heat of the bed, but better by resting in the bed. So this much should be important enough for you to understand mercury. Yes, you can always read from books, huh?
Yes.
So you know today so many heroes, huh? Genghis Khan, Stalin, Peter Sellers, Hitler, Napoleon, Bonaparte.
So can a woman be
of course.
It's not like to just be dictatorial.
The mind part of Mercury does not fit much into femininity of a woman, let me tell you. Maybe there, but I have never prescribed to any woman Mercury at the level of mind. No. 37 years, not a woman of Mercury. Maybe I didn't see. There may be. World is always big. But it's not a feminine, it's all bloody masculine.
What would you see with that psychology that in a woman?
No, you cannot, because this is very characteristic. Maybe of some women who are into politics, yes. Maybe some women who are in military, yes. Maybe some women who are president of a country, yes. Or maybe some women who are in Hollywood industry. There you will pick up Mercury a lot, because Mercury are talented.
Or what?
Talented. In television industry, you will pick them up. In music industry, you will pick them up. In politics, you will pick them up a lot.
A lot.
A lot. George Bush, you said, no? If he comes to know you have it, Christina.
Well, I don't know him that well, but I don't know him. I think he likes his murk aspect.
Okay, anyway, let's pray that we are miles away from them. Okay.
What about the hormones in women that... what happens that it's...
I don't know. You see, there are many...
going to the murk state?
We really don't know, but this is what I feel. If anything happens during menses, it has to do something with the hormones, you know? Mm-hmm. The hormones are affecting very badly. A woman... I've never seen, honestly, a woman telling me that I want to murder somebody during menses. I have not got that symptom. So as I said, my experience with the constitutional Mercury woman is zero. My experience lies with the children and Mercury a lot, and adults to some extent, but children a lot. Lot of Mercury you will see in, you know why? I see that a lot in India, because our water contains lot of Mercury, and with lot of spraying of fertilizers on vegetables and fruits, we get lot of Mercury. And these kids are always eating all those things, you know, junk things. And that's why the mercury poisoning is destroying them. And then, of course, the mind becomes insane. So maybe many times I feel that why I see so many mercury in pediatrics age group, this because attention deficit disorder has become
common.
Very common. Very common.
So then don't they
both?
Do they prove the mercury? Because it's
I don't know. Because many times I take a sample of blood to see the mercury level, arsenic level, lead level, aluminum level. Many times they are high. And so there has to be some reflection of mercury somewhere.
So
So, but if somebody is poisoned by mercury, like too many fillings and things, and they produce the symptoms of mercury,
do you treat
them with mercury or something that antidote the mercury?
No, depends on the symptoms. I will select a remedy, but I will tell them to remove the amalgams of mercury for sure. Mm-hmm. For sure. But I have seen this. You remove amalgam and lot of symptoms comes up. At that time, mercury acts beautifully in 30 potency. 30, that's the best potency to counteract that affection of removal of amalgam.
Suggest all your patients to have them removed?
If they are heavy, yes. But in India, more than mercury, they put a lot of gold in their teeth. Lot of gold.